Hi, welcome to our weekly tech tip number 5. Today I want to show you a little bit how to reuse a layer and that you can easily use it for the next project. And for that I will use the Simonine out of the box sample today, the Fano controller. So first let me start the post-configured application. So what is the use case here? Two things we want to achieve. The first one is we want to have a redundant tool output. Means that the tool changes output in every start of pass. And the second one is we want to reuse this layer on a later point, and I want to show the workflow or the best practice workflow for that. So first to the use case. So I've connected the two things today in this weekly tech tip. What does it means? Currently, in the first operation, we have this tool change here. That's fine. And in the second operation, cavity top, you see here it's the same tool, but there is no tool change output. So now this is a very common functionality. I need sometimes in different post processors, and for that one now we want to create a layer where we maybe on later sessions also include other stuff. And already provided on the NX Manufacturing Forum to reuse that. So for that best practice workflow, first I need the functionality, right? So that means I go to the layer manager and let's create a new layer here. Let us named community layer and community layer, that is a TCL file name. We want that this is created in a directory inside of the post processor. We need a TCL file. Currently, we don't need a definition file, and we don't need a user-defined event file for UDEs. So created. Now it's sourced in the post processor. Click OK, and we can start our coding. So you see here, it's directly there, community layer. And for sure, it's empty. So in preparation for that, and I will reuse a few stuff what I already posted in the manufacturing forum. So what is it? Renamed a little bit community layer. What we want to do here is in the start of pass, we call a procedure named Siemens Digital Industries redundant tool output. In this procedure, we remember the last tool if it's exist, and if it's exist, then we will output it in the next operation again with a Momdo template. So what you see here, this is a template name. It's controlled by a property. That is the third part here. I don't want to go in detail. But finally, there's a property or two properties. The one is I want to have this option on, means every time the tool will be outputted in each start of pass. And what is the template name which is called behind? Okay, so let's do that. Okay, now here you see in the tool change, there are two new properties. So I extend the UI of Post Configurator here. I have the option on off and the template name, which should be called, so you can extend the block template whatever you want. Okay, so let's post process again. And now we have our face top operation T1 M6, and we have the cavity top operation, and again T1 M6. And the last one where we have a tool change, for sure we have a different T number. So that's from a technical side. Now I want to reuse this layer for the next time when I create a post processor, because I don't want to do this again and again and again. So what I have to do here, I'm ready with that one. Go again to the layer manager, go to the community layer. And now I say export this layer. And I export this layer, and this is now really important. It depends on the NX version, and there are, you can also locate it on a network drive wherever you want. Finally, or basically, in the Mach resource post configurator folder, you have this post template folder. In that one, you should create a folder like add-on. And in that one, we save our layer. And that's it. So now this is one step you have to do manually. We have to include this in the environment when we want to create the next post processor. Let me go to this folder. So we are here, post configurator, post template, add on, and there is this community layer. And we have now two files here. The first one is a TCL file, our implementation. The second one is a PSL file, which is at the end the content of this layer. It describes that the community layer is inside of this file. It's XML, so you can open it. Let me shortly show here. You can open it, and there are some other options I will explain maybe in one of the next technical weekly tech tips. And so what I now have to do that I can create a post processor with this layer directly during the creation process, I have to modify this post registry. I recommend do a backup of the original one so that you can go back every time. I will change in this case, I mean not best practice, the original one. To do that, I will copy me one of this manufacturer layer here. So copy the manufacturer layer. Ctrl-4. And I want to name it like community layer. That is what you will see in the UI during the create post processor. And I have to point to the PSL file now. So that means add on and community layer and community layer. One thing I want to mention here, ideally directly copy the names. This avoid wrong naming issues here. But let me double check community layer, the PSL, that should match. The base controller, that means under which controller this should be possible. So in this case, let's say we want to have it for FANUC, and maybe we want also have it available directly for Synumeric. Then you have duplicate the entries here, and we say it's also available for Synumeric 840D. Okay, so let's test it. Click cancel. Now I want to create a new post processor. And yeah, we have an issue here, fail to find. So something goes wrong on my side. I have to double check now. So let me open the folder. And as I said, the better way is to copy the name and not writing it. So you see it's my issue. It is not an underscore, it's a white space between. So save it again. Okay. So create new post processor. Now it's loading. And if I now select Synumeric, you see in the manufacturer, I have my community layer here. So let's do that. Now we create a Synumeric post processor for that one. My Synumeric, define an output location. Okay, we want to create a subfolder, no machine level, and okay. So now you see directly you have the community layer inside, and when I go to the tool change, I directly have my property. It's on and tool change. So for sure now you have to check, okay, which template is called. So in this case it's tool change by number. So let's double check, it should work directly. Okay, call up. So we have the face top T1 M6 and again cavity top T1 M6. Now the final validation, we switch it off, save the modification, post-process, and again let's check the code T1 M6 and no one T1 M6. So, and now if you do additional customization, that is the workflow, the best practice workflow. I did do some additional customization. The only thing you need after you finished, export this layer again to the folder, and you are done and can reuse every time. So, hope you enjoy this tech tip. If you have any cool ideas to extend this community layer, so it's shared on the NX Manufacturing Forum and the post-processor group, feel free to add something and share it with all of us. I will be happy to get some feedback from you. Okay, hope enjoy. Bye bye.